So, neural networks. You may have heard a bit about them, and based on the fact that you clicked on this video, you are probably interested in them. In this video, my goal is to introduce the basic functions of a neural net, and in subsequent videos, I will go into detail, explaining how exactly neural nets do what they do. Before we begin, I just want to point out that what I'm currently referring to is artificial neural networks, that is, software that emulates what a real human neural network would do. For simplicity, in this video and in the following videos, I will just be referring to them as neural networks, or even just as neural nets. With that out of the way, let's dive into the world of AI, or artificial intelligence, and neural networks. The term neural network describes a subcategory of AI. AI itself is defined as a branch of computer science dealing with the simulation of intelligent behavior in computers. Neural networks are a specific way of doing this that involves the modeling of the human brain itself and the nervous system. It has recently been extremely successful. The following are some of its applications: handwriting recognition, image compression, stock exchange predictions, and even image recognition, or recognizing what is in an image, such as a Labrador Retriever, cargo ship, and sneakers. The basic idea of a neural network is that you can take some input data, or usually many inputs, and perform some operations to them. And based on this, you can get an output, a number, that can mean many things based on the context. Of course, you first need to find the right operations in a process called training. The aim of this video is not to explain how this works, so I will leave it at that for now. As I said before, this will be the aim of the following videos. Now, I will present a much simpler example and explain how the neural net could be used to figure out the solution. For example, you may want to classify flowers into one of two species based on the lengths and widths of its petals. In this case, you would have two inputs, the length and width of that flower's petal, and one output, the classification of the flower, or basically what species it is. Keep in mind that inputs would be numbers, and as a result, the output will be as well. You could say that any flower with an output above 0.5 would be one species, and anything below 0.5 is another. As I have previously said, before the neural net can successfully classify the flowers, you'll need to adjust the operations that are performed in the training step. In this case, this would involve using raw data, the lengths and widths of petals, and species of a particular flower, for many flowers, to adjust the operations, making the neural net capable of classification. How exactly we do this will be one of the main topics of subsequent videos. Basically, training will require inputs and outputs from real data in order for the neural net to create accurate predictions of the output when new inputs are presented. Now that you understand some of the applications and uses of a neural network, and a basic idea of how they work, let's continue our journey, exploring the ins and outs of neural networks. In our next video, we will discuss the basic structure of a neural network. In the video following this, we will take a look at how we can make our neural network capable of training. I'll see you then. If you want to ask me a question, or just tell me and the community about something that you think is relevant, leave a comment in the comment section down below. If you enjoyed the video and want to see more, please like, subscribe, and hit the notification icon. This will be an easy, free way of supporting the channel.